In this video, I'm just going to do a bunch of practice problems where we balance a lot of different chemical equations. And so if you feel like you don't know how to do these quite yet, go ahead and watch my intro to balancing video. This video is going to assume that you kind of have the steps down and you just want to see a bunch of practice problems get done. I'm also going to be giving the reaction type of each problem, just because a lot of teachers usually will ask for that too. So, starting with our problem on the left-hand side, the first thing we're going to do for all these problems is to separate them into the left-hand side and the right-hand side and list out the different elements we have. Now I'm going to go through and list how many of each element we have at the beginning of the problem. So on the left-hand side, we have one zinc, one hydrogen, one chlorine. On the right-hand side, we have one zinc, two hydrogens, two chlorines. All right, so zinc is balanced for now, so I'm just gonna start with hydrogen. So I'm going to increase the left-hand side by putting a 2 here. Now cross out both elements that affects hydrogen and chlorine. And so now I'm going to have 2 hydrogens and 2 chlorines. And for this is balanced now. So I'm done, and I can either leave all of these blank spots blank, or I can put a coefficient of 1 in there. It doesn't matter. For this problem, I'll go ahead and just do 1, 1, 1. We can see all of our technical coefficients. And this reaction type is single replacement. And we can tell that because over here on the left-hand side, we have zinc completely by itself. It's not bonded to any other element. And then over here, we have hydrogen completely by itself. It's not bonded to any other element. Even though it's bonded to another hydrogen, it's still by itself as an element. And then we can see this swap occurred. So hydrogen and chlorine used to be together, and now chlorine is with zinc instead of hydrogen. All right, next, going ahead, cutting it in half, listing all our elements, writing down how many we have of each at the very start of this equation. And now starting to balance. So potassium's okay for now, chlorine's okay for now. What we really have to do is this oxygen, right? And so what we're going to have to look for is the lowest common multiple that we can get 3 and 2 to. And so that is 6. And so we need to get both these to 6. That means that 2 will have to get multiplied by 3. And 3 will have to get multiplied by 2. So putting those coefficients in there, we have, and now let's see what we have. Now we have 2 potassiums, 2 chlorines, 6 oxygens. We have 1 potassium on the right-hand side, 1 chlorine on the right-hand side, and we have 6 oxygens. So now all we have to do is balance potassium and chlorine on the right-hand side. We can do that by putting a 2 right here. And now we're completely balanced. And this reaction goes from having one molecule to having 2 molecules. So this is a decomposition reaction. All right, so our next problem. Starting out, we have 8 sulfurs, 2 fluorines. Over here, we have 1 sulfur, 6 fluorines. So, all right, first I'm going to balance the sulfurs. I need to make this sulfur on the right-hand side an 8. So I need to put an 8 here, and that affects both sulfur and fluorine. So now I have 8 times this invisible subscript of 1. I have 8 sulfurs, and I have 8 times this subscript of 6. So I have 48 fluorines. And so now going over here, I have to somehow make this number 48. I can see my subscript is 2, so the only number that's going to make sense is 24. Now 24 times 2, I have 48 fluorines, and this is completely balanced. And so this reaction type goes from having 2 molecules. I have my S8 and I have my F2, and then at the end I only have this one. So this is called a synthesis reaction. And next. All right, so starting to balance iron. And here, I'm really just picking whatever I feel like balancing first. We could start with oxygen, it doesn't really matter, but I just feel like doing it in order. So 2 here. And now we have to balance this oxygen. And so once again, we can see that we have our 2 and our 3. So we need to kind of do our lowest common multiple strategy again. Basically, what's the first number that both of these can get to? That's going to be 6. That's the goal. And so we get to 6 over here by multiplying by 2, and we get to 6 over here by multiplying by 3. And that's what our coefficients are going to be. So plugging 3 in here and 2 in here, Now we can go ahead and cross out everything that was affected. So here, now I have 6 oxygens. Here, now I have 4 irons and 6 oxygens. And so now I can see I have to balance my irons again. I have to go ahead and get rid of this 2 and replace it with a 4. And now I'm completely balanced. And this, once again, has 2 molecules becoming 1. So this is a synthesis. And now doing a combustion problem. We know this is combustion because our products are carbon dioxide and water, and because our reactants are some kind of fuel which contains carbon and hydrogen, and it reacts with O2, which is just air in the atmosphere. So any type of fuel burning that ends up making carbon dioxide and water, that's going to be combustion. So going ahead and starting off. Just a little tip, for combustion reactions, you always start off on the product side with 1, 2, and 3 if you go carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. And so now going ahead and starting to balance, we're going to do oxygen last because that appears in 3 out of 4 molecules, whereas carbon and hydrogen appear in 2 out of 4 molecules. So we need this to be 2. So we put that there. Now we have to cross out carbon and oxygen. We now have 2 carbons and we have 2 times 2, so 4, plus this one still, we have 1 oxygen, so we have 5 oxygens right now. Now balancing hydrogen, so we need to get to 6 on the right-hand side, so we put a 3 here. Now instantly cross out hydrogen and oxygen, those are inaccurate. So now we have 3 times 2, 6 hydrogens, and for oxygen, we still have our 2 times 2 from here, plus now we have our 3 times our invisible subscript of 1, so we have a total of 7 oxygens. All right, so now we have to balance. We have to get our oxygens on this side to 7, but we can see that's gonna be hard, right? Because if we do 2 times 3, that'll give us 6. If we have a coefficient of 4, which means 2 times 4, that'll give us 8 oxygens. We don't want either of those. So what we do with combustion to kind of do it faster than just continuing to make all of our numbers higher is we temporarily put a decimal in here. So we say, okay, what number, even if we break our rule of having just whole numbers, is going to give us 7 oxygens? And that number is 2 times 3.5. This does equal 7. So temporarily, we're going to put a 3.5 here. And now everything is completely balanced because 3.5 times 2 is 7, and now I have a balanced reaction. But because I can't leave my coefficient of 3.5 here, I have to multiply every coefficient by 2. This is just how I get it out of being a decimal. So now if I multiply every coefficient by 2, first remember that I actually had a 1 in front of my C2H6, even though I didn't write anything, it means an implied 1. And now multiplying, I have 2, 7, 4, 6. And so these are going to be my final coefficients. So now I'm going to go ahead and replace my decimals with my final coefficients. And let's go ahead and make sure that everything is balanced. So I have 2 times 2, 4 carbons, 2 times 6, 12 hydrogens, 7 times 2, 14 oxygens, 4 times 1, 4 carbons, 6 times 2, 12 hydrogens. And now for oxygens, I have 4 times 2 plus 6 times 1. So that gets me 14 oxygens. Great, and now everything is balanced and I don't have that decimal anymore. Hope drilling these practice problems with balancing was helpful for you. Again, if I went too fast for you, go ahead and watch my intro to balancing. That's where I go super slow and really explain all these concepts. And happy studying. Hey, I hope you liked that video. Please feel free to subscribe, click around and watch my other tutorials. And as always, happy studying.